Good morning, YouTube. So I wanted to show you the little modification I'm doing to this AC panel meter. This happens to be the PZEM-021. There's the back panel for it. And this mod probably works for all of these meters. They're very similar circuit boards. They all have this yellow 1 microfarad 270 volt capacitor. And this capacitor is your capacitive dropper that feeds the power supply for this board. So you have the incoming power comes in here, runs through the capacitor, then runs through this high power current limiting resistor, and then underneath here are your 3.3 and 5 volt regulators for all of the logic on the board. And the trick is you just cut the lead from the circuit board on this side of the capacitor, and that's the one that connects to the line input. And then the other side here, the capacitor and resistor are tied together, but on this end you just have the capacitor, and then you have a little surface mount bleed resistor underneath, or discharge resistor. So what I did was I put a 470K resistor across the capacitors. By cutting this lead, you're eliminating that discharge resistor. And then I just soldered a wire onto the lifted leg of this capacitor and the resistor, and I'm running this wire out through a little notch that I cut in the side of the case there, right next to the terminal block. This will be my power feed for the panel meter, and then on this side is your neutral. So you'll hook your line and neutral here, and then the load goes out here and back in here, and then through the current shunt that's connecting those. With this meter, the way to think about it here, if we can look at my little diagram, the way you wire this meter in is, here's my AC power supply, and this is the wire that comes off of the variable output of the variac, goes to the two outlets that are on the front of the supply, and then flows back to the variac. But this could be, you know, anything over here. But the idea is you just cut the wire that's feeding your load, and you cut the wire that's coming back from the load, and you just stick the meter in to those two cut wires. So your line comes in and the meter replaces the cut with this jumper. So there's a jumper on the back of the circuit board. Your line comes in and then comes right back out. So this is the wire you cut. You stick both cut ends into one side of the meter. You go to your load. You bring your neutral wire from the load back. Again, this wire's been cut. One goes into one side of the sense resistor, one goes into the other side, and that's your return or neutral side of the circuit. This is the one wire that was cut, shoved into the two terminals. This is the other wire that was cut, shoved into those two terminals, and then I'm adding this fifth wire. I'm cutting the wire right here off of this big capacitor and feeding this from a separate constant power source. So that should be the simple way to wire this up. And yeah, I wanted to give a shout out to Jim Connor. I'll put a link to his video where he put one of these meters in his homemade variable AC power supply, and he mentioned doing this very mod. I don't think he did a video on that, so I wanted to do a video to show exactly what you have to do to get this to work. And again, this should apply to all of these liquid crystal four reading meters. There's the PZEM-021, you have this 061 model that I used that has the current transformer. They all have very similar looking circuit boards inside, and you just have to find which of the two legs of this large capacitor here is connected to the terminal block. So I just used my meter and checked this pin with all four, and I checked this pin, and it turns out this pin here is connected to these two screws on the terminal block. So it's pretty easy to find which one is connected, and then you just cut that wire and run a separate wire out. The only complication of doing that is when you separate these wires here, you've now defined this wire as the line voltage, and you've defined this other side here as the neutral side of the connector. If you don't separate this wire out, it really doesn't matter. There's, you know, it's AC voltage. You can call one side line and the other side neutral. It really doesn't matter. You've got to make sure that you keep track of which side is which, because once you do that, you've made that distinction now. So you got to remember what you're working with. So anyway, big thanks to Jim Connor for that idea. And let's get this buttoned up and see if it works. So if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.